If you try to insert or update a value in an SQL database with single quotes inside it, you might have issues running the SQL or getting the data into the table correctly. To solve these problems, you'll have to do something called escaping to the single quote. In this video, you'll learn how to correctly include or escape single quotes in SQL. We'll see how it can be done in Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, and PostgreSQL, and it should work with other databases as well. Let's get into it. So what is escaping? When you're working with text values in SQL, you use single quote characters to surround the text. This could be in a query like this, where you're selecting a text value, or it could be when you're inserting a text value, like this query. Notice that the words ABC company are included in single quotes. But what if you have a single quote as part of your string value? For example, if you insert a record with a value of O'Reilly, this would cause an issue in your IDE because there are three single quotes. The database and your IDE do not know where your string ends. To allow single quotes to be used within a string, you need to escape them. Escaping a character is where you indicate to the IDE and the database that a particular character is part of the string and not part of the statement you're trying to run. There are a few methods you can use to escape single quotes, which I'll show you now. The simplest method to escape single quotes in SQL is to use two single quotes. When you want to use a single quote inside your string, add another single quote right after it. For example, the insert statement here will insert the value of O'Reilly into the table. This insert statement has two single quotes inside the word O'Reilly. When we select from the table, we only see one single quote. This is because the two single quotes are processed as one quote being used to escape the other quote. This technique works in Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, and PostgreSQL. Another technique you can use in MySQL and PostgreSQL is to add a backslash before the quote. Inside your string, add a backslash character before the single quote. You can then proceed with running your statement. In this example, the insert statement will run and insert the value of O'Reilly with the single quote correctly. Oracle offers another method you can use called literal quoting. This means you put the letter Q in front of the word, then the escape character, then square brackets to surround your string value. So, for a value of O'Reilly, an insert statement would look like this. We can see the Q and the single quote before the string. If we select the value from the table, the O'Reilly is shown correctly. In SQL Server and Oracle, you can use the CHR function. This function returns a character from the specified ASCII code. It isn't strictly an escaping of a character because you replace the single quote with this function, but it is another option for you. Here's a sample insert statement with the single quote replaced with the CHR function with a parameter of 39, which is the code for a single quote. When you select from this table, you see the value of O'Reilly. So, as we can see, there are a few different methods of escaping single quotes in SQL. In summary, we have two single quotes, a backslash, literal quoting, and using the CHR function. And that brings us to the end of this video on escaping single quotes. If you learned something new from this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn more about database design and development, visit databasestar.com. That's where I share my best database-related content. Which tip from this video was the most helpful? Was it the fact that two single quotes is a simple and common solution, or using the CHR function, or something else? Thanks for watching.